Welcome everyone to today's video. A little bit vintage tinkering again, and no worries, although this might look similar to what we've done already with this recently new old stock 486 board here. There will usually be something new in each of my videos. So the major point, for example, also testing this 12-volt DC module with the ATX converter thing here. Yes, a little bit flying wire there, but that should survive this test, I hope. The main point of this video is testing two things. So I got here also, as I mentioned, a Weser local bus card that I quickly need to test. Not that it doesn't work. And also at the same time, some completely new other CF card dongle. Because making the video when this 486 board arrived, I realized I still have not got another one, because the first one I ordered had a laptop 2.5-inch connector and I wanted a regular one. So we will quickly test this and the Weser local bus card today. In contrast to the previous CF card adapter that has a laptop connector here, 2.5-inch, 44-pin, and this one has a standard IDE connector with additional power source there. And no, it's not the same PCB. And no, this is not a paid promotion. This is just what we got here. So let's pack this back in here and use it as a spacer here, just in case. And as you can see, I'm not one of those people who's sending those small things back to Amazon or so. Even if I order something that did not match 100% to what I needed, usually, especially those small things, I just keep. You never know what you can use them for. Some people really wrap stuff. And another wrap. Never can have enough wrapping here. I shouldn't say it too negatively. More wrap is always better than less wrap. So these are this short-lived Weser local bus cards. Looks actually quite okay-ish. Sold in 1993 according to this warranty sticker here. And as I probably mentioned in the video, this is a Cirrus Logic GD5428 that should have some bit BLT acceleration as well as a hard recursor. Otherwise I would not have got this. And as I mentioned also, for sharing with other 386, I want an ET4000 W32.4 bit BLT and hardware cursor for 386. So this is the predecessor of PCI, Weser local bus. It was relatively short-lived because this was rather tightly coupled to the 486 bus, so a rather direct connection as far as I read. From how it sounds to me, they've mostly done PCI for the Pentium and of course other architectures. As I said, we never had this. I only saw this at my neighbor, and of course we didn't take it in and out there as this stuff was expensive and we kids didn't want to break stuff. I always found it funny that this high-density stuff here for the 32-bit bus connects here, and they are reusing the 8-bit slot for the power. Maybe more, don't know, quite some. Maybe another day we figure out which lines are connected there. And due to the construction with this 32-bit high-density part here, all these Weser local bus cards were as long, and maybe also a reason why they were not as popular, because this large PCB obviously made them rather expensive to produce, and they were also not the most easy to press in here. I read this already, and I will also not get any more of these Weser local bus cards, I think, unless someone of you wants to send one here. This is just one test here for my... That was tough and tight though. I plan to most only have this as an historic example in my test collection, and as per the previous video, also the I/O card for the hard drive here, which we will use for the SD card. And this is coded, so one master, two slave. Somehow really wonder what they were thinking with 1-2 master slave, 2-3 slave master. Confusing. I also took two of these modules out. In the previous video I had 4 4-megabyte modules in there, but somehow this was not entirely stable, not even stable rebooting, so I took 2 out. Okay, this virtual machine is also updating finally a little bit. This is not a Windows promotion, I'm just fighting with Windows 10 updates in my VM. You can read details about this on Twitter. And then we also need power. Wonderful, this module does not have floppy power. I guess I need to find a floppy power connection thing. And I found one in our vintage basement junk. box, so that goes here. Otherwise, you could also connect a lab power supply and things like that. Wait a second, this is the opposite male and female situation here. Okay, but now I found a matching adapter. Why you would need this other one for what is not entirely clear to me. Whatever, so next try. So, CF card is in. Then probably we can try to power it up and hope we did not short here anything. Just a completely normal professional flying wire test setup here. And VGA goes there. And I guess this looks normal, nothing shorting. Then let's power it up. So let's test with a matrix card just for the reference. Okay, so with a Mystic it works. The only question is this Chinese DC board at fault, or is it the VESA local bus? And obviously back in the day and such, we read that this VESA local bus is really sensitive, connected directly to the processor bus, so much too vintage stuff. So attempt number two with this VESA local bus, this time in the first slot there. It's of course a little bit of a pity that this is so scratched there. Maybe there's some contact not perfect, but as often with this vintage stuff, you just don't know what might be wrong. Okay, you see the card is doing something. Now we have some picture there, so it is working at least a little bit, just not 100%ly. And the question is now, of course, is it the bus? Is it the board? Is it the configuration? Is it the connector? But okay, so much too. VESA local bus was a little bit flanky back in the day. Here's also VESA weight states. Maybe I try to play around with this VESA weight state and CPU speed configuration here. So much to the test today. Our VESA local bus card probably works, otherwise the picture would probably be total garbage. So this is probably just some writes going corrupted to this high-speed VESA local bus that everyone said was sensitive and quite directly coupled to the CPU, and due to this quite sensitive to timing and whatsoever. This jumpers for weight states are bridged on the board, so closed is one weight state and closed here is CPU speed greater than 33 MHz. That is already bridged on the board, nothing to change. There, these two jumpers. So my general warning applies. Be careful what you buy for your vintage stuff, and in general this is eBay prices. This card wasn't the most expensive because this was just for my VESA local bus testing. As I said, ideally I wanted a ET4000W32i also to share it with a C36. But yeah, if you buy stuff from eBay, even if it works, it may not work in this combination. And that's mostly it for today. I hope you learned something, and don't forget to share, like and subscribe. And maybe another day I try a slower CPU and see if this makes this more stable or so. Update, I plugged in a DX25 and still no change, still not perfect, so yeah. Wonder if pressing here and resetting helps. Okay, these contacts are the issue. Wait a second, when I press there it indeed changes. Pressing changed the picture a little bit, so maybe these are this VESA local bus contacts there after all. So much to you want VESA local bus not. Now pressing changes it significantly, so maybe these are these contacts. Thank you very much, seller of this mainboard, maybe. So yeah, probably go ISA or PCI, but not VESA local bus. Can't recommend. Of course the sample size is 1, but I would not expect other pieces to work that much more reliable if you buy random stuff. PCI just works, as you can see, also with the DX266, so yeah, go for that, I would say. You can also share this with more systems where you can swap it back and forth. A free bizarre Windows tip at the end. As you know, I mostly use Linux, and this virtual machine was not updating anymore. And by the way, I hope this is the one where I have Visual Studio now. So I removed the last snapshot and continue with the state from a year ago. And I really wondered, I resized the virtual disk in QEMU even two times, first 8 and then 4 gigabyte. And Windows would still not show here more than 32 gigabyte, or would allow me here to extend the volume. And then I was already rebooting, extending it 4 gigabyte again and so on, nothing's changed. But actually clicking refresh here helps. This is bizarre. I really wonder why reboot doesn't help and refresh is required, but yeah, so it's fun with Windows. Oh, I didn't want to shrink, so it's where the obvious things do not just work and they need a refresh button. Let's continue with the update. Really annoying that this update sometimes stops working. And if it's related to disk space, at least it should say out of disk space, or not even attempt the update if the disk space is not available. Anyway, that's it for today. I need to sort the not fully working Visa local card away now, and I hope to see you soon for the next videos to come.